What's up, everybody? I'm Andrew with Indie Direct, doing this video in collaboration with MGN TV. If you want to check out my channel, I review only indie games. The link will be in the description. But today, we are going to be looking at Chicken Police Painted Red, releasing today on all platforms from the developers over at The Wild Gentleman, a point-and-click film noir detective adventure game set in the fictional world of the wilderness, with narrative-based gameplay, gritty themes, and an absurd, unique sense of humor. And just to let you know, there won't be any spoilers, but I will go into small amount of detail about the game in the beginning, and a day one patch is planned to improve some aspects of the game, so a few things could change based on what they change from this review. You play as Sonny Featherland, an investigator for the Clawville Police Department for over 20 years. Clawville is a city where predators and prey have been living alongside each other in peace for almost a millennia. Or that's what they want you to believe. Sonny has 121 days before his retirement, most spent at the bottom of a bottle, till he finds a mysterious yet elegant antelope in his apartment. Miss Deborah Ibanez, who has been sent to you from her employer, who is in fear for their life. You are soon told that their employer is Miss Natasha Katzenko, the girlfriend of the notorious Ivan Wessler, crime kingpin that runs the city's underground. With your friend and partner, Marty McChicken, you unravel the strings of this yarn ball to solve the mystery of a lifetime. Chicken Police, first and foremost, is a narrative driven with hours of voice dialogue between 30 unique and colorful characters, each having a seedier background than the one prior. That's one great thing that makes this game fantastic, is its world building. Every character has a fleshed out backstory. The town, the stores, and the politics of this town have a story to tell from the eyes of Sonny and Marty, giving the world you will spend about 4 to 6 hours in weight and meaning. During your time wandering the 25 different locations, you will talk and interact with the heathens that inhabit this city, question them about others or of important evidence, and interrogate the ones in question, which is a very big part of this game. Once initiated in the interrogation, Sonny will give you a small hint on how to question the suspect, and you have 2 to 4 questions you can ask them. You must select the one that you see fit, and depending on the accuracy, you receive negative or positive points towards the investigation bar, which will give you a grade after each encounter. Sadly, it seems like this is the only reason the interrogation is here, is for the grade. Most of the valuable info is given to you when you can only select one question to ask. You can mess up the grade, but it seems like you will never fail in the investigation because the game won't let you make that mistake or miss the big clues that would lead to dead ends. It's a very linear game in this regards of the mechanics. You can go to time-sensitive locations between the main locations to pick up additional information, but it seems like small things that fill out a person or place's background and not an integral part of the story. Another part of this game is connecting the pieces of the investigation at the end of each chapter, choosing the person and the evidence to make the connection and understand the state of the case. Sadly, this is very linear itself. You can't come up with your own conclusions. You have to pick the photo, the evidence, and the conclusion that they want you to pick. Instead of letting you make your mistakes, it holds your hand all the way to the end, and there really is no way to deviate off the intended course. I was hoping for more of a free investigation like LA Noir, to where I can mess it up and I have all the incorrect evidence. Though I understand this is more story focused and wants to tell the story the whole way through. I came to this realization early on, but my investigation bone was itching and I felt like I had connected the pieces before the game would let me. Graphics and sound design are another fantastic part of this game. Graphically, this game is a mix of 2D and 3D designs and contemporary visuals of old cinema. 1940s feel is all over the place, from the buildings to even the characters' outfits and speech patterns. The design of the characters are also not incredibly jarring. With the animal heads and the slight fur transition to the human body, it becomes more or less believable to the mind and not putting into that uncanny valley. If only the new Cats movie would have taken this route, maybe we wouldn't have all been so scarred. Sound design will stand out great to anyone who is a big fan of a film noir or big band songs. So many great scores in this game that I can only hope that the soundtrack will release as well. Background and voiceover work are perfect, crisp and well-balanced. Nothing seems to overpower another and work in harmony. So, should you play Chicken Police? If you are a very story-driven person that loves a good detective mystery, yes, absolutely. You will enjoy the well-written story and a few twists that are given along the way. For detectives out there, it can leave you wanting more, but it's still something you can sink your teeth in. If you guys do want to check it out, there'll be a Steam link down in the description, as well as a link to the Discord if you guys want to join and talk to the crew. Thank you for watching this video, guys. Don't forget to leave a like, lets us know if we're doing something right, and don't forget to subscribe so you guys can keep on top of really all the games that are coming out in the very near future. But like always, guys, I'll see you in the next video and have fun.